Eugene, if you could ban any card in the game right now, what would it be?
Oh, that's easy. Every single card with the word Orcist on it.
I know you hate Orcist, Eugene, but I'm trying to be serious here because I do not have a preference whatsoever anymore, because I really feel like that if you build a decent enough deck and you choose decent enough cards, then you can at least do decent yourself.
Well, thinking about it that way, the easiest target would be... Besides Orcist.
Besides Orcist, yeah.
Well, besides Orcist, the easiest target would be Hornadrones.
Why does everyone hate on Hornadrones?
It's the most generic, therefore it's the most obvious.
Wouldn't you want it to stick around, though, because it's generic, so that even you could take advantage of it being a rogue player yourself?
What makes you feel like I play rogue?
I don't know, I just kind of always got that feeling.
Well, either way, it's just better for the game if it goes, because it lets you link climb way too easily.
More junk's gonna come out anyways, not to mention a master rule change just around the corner.
They'll fix Yu-Gi-Oh! They'll get it right next time. They'll make it how it used to be. They'll make it good. They'll get it right. They'll make it. Konami will fix it. They will fix it. They will make it right. Konami will fix it. They will make it right.
Are you just in total denial about everything?
Leave me alone!
I want to start this video off by giving a huge shout out to Chris Sanchez, guys. You guys have seen his artwork around on the channel before. I'm actually on this mat wall right over here. The Blue Eyes Ultimate Dragon and my Cyber Dragon mat, all drawn by him, And the guy is so nice. He's so cool. He gave me another mat to put on the wall. It's so cool. It's so awesome. It's Cyber Dragon, like, eating Harold's head. Like, I think it's really awesome. These are, you know, two of my favorite decks of all time. And he hooked me up. He really did hook me up with this hand-drawn mat that's gonna look awesome on the wall. But not only did he give me this to hang up on the wall, guys, but he gave me this one to give out to you. Yes, he drew a second mat. He drew two of them. He was like, hey, you know, keep one, give another one away. And I was like, all right, yeah, I'll totally do that. Thank you. So yeah, that's what we're doing. If you guys want a chance to win this mat, what this is a female Elemental Hero Absolute Zero. Yeah, that's what this is. This is a girl version of Elemental Hero Absolute Zero. He drew this out for you guys. And if you want to win this mat, all you have to do is reply to the post on the Twitter. That's it. I'm gonna make a post on the Twitter. Just reply to it with something that'll grab my attention. I will go back and forth at random and pick something, and I'll send this your way. I'll message you before the next video and get your address, and we'll send it your way. I mean, I feel like there should be something more for these giveaways, but really it's super easy, guys. You just comment or reply and I give you free crap. Shoutouts to MetaMats.com and 1UpTCG, my sponsors, the best sponsors in all of Yu-Gi-Oh! If you guys want 10% off of mats, go ahead and enter in the code YugiJesus on MetaMats.com and you get 10% off of mats. That's it. And if you guys want 10% off of cards, enter in the code NONO2020 on 1UpTCG.com and you get 10% off of cards.
The blessings of Yu-Gi-Oh! Jesus never end, guys. They never end.
So in today's video, though, guys, what we're going to do is we're going to be opening up a discussion. We're going to be talking about my current favorite card in the game, and that's going to open up a discussion into the upcoming January ban list. Now, I'm not going to hop on that bandwagon and just, you know, make the whole video a ban list prediction. Ugh, no, we're not doing that. That is done. Every single Yu-Gi-Oh! Format, guys, and I don't know who has a preference at this point. I don't have a preference. Honestly, everything that should still be on the list is still on the list. If anything, more things could come off the list, but we're gonna get into that, guys. We're gonna open up and start off this discussion by talking about my current favorite card in the game right now, Barricade Board Blocker. Not the coolest and best looking card, I know, but he is a badass card nonetheless. And I'm going to cheat here, guys, and use the laptop. Its effect reads, if this card is Link Summoned, you can discard one card. During the end phase of this turn, add one continuous or field spell card from your graveyard to your hand. You can only use the effect of Barricade Board Blocker once per turn. Face-up spells you control cannot be destroyed by your opponent's card effects. This card is a generic Link 2 with arrows pointing left and pointing down, so you can use it as an extender or as a starter, and it only requires two monsters with different names to make, so it's very, very generic. And not only is it generic, but it has an amazing effect. It actually has two amazing effects, guys. It lets you discard a card to let you recover a field or a continuous spell from your graveyard to your hand. So you get that recoverability from the graveyard, and you don't even have to have a field. I'm gonna note this right now, guys. You don't even have to have a field or continuous in your grave already in order to get that discard effect. Just right when it's Link Summoned, activate to discard. That's it. You don't have to already have something in your grave to recover. Nothing like that. It's just at the end phase, it's going to try to get something back. That's all it does, guys. That's all it does. And it protects your own field spells from your opponent's card effects. That's it. It protects your field spells from your opponent's card effects. But since this is so generic to make, though, it's a generic discard outlet. Any two monsters with different names, and you get a discard outlet for Malicious, Destrudo, Glow Up Bulb, Dot Scraper. I mean, guys, you name it. You name it. This is a discard outlet for it. It's a really great card. I think this is an overlooked card. It's a common out of what did this even come out of? It's a common out of something. Rising Rampage, guys. Common out of Rising Rampage. That is the set that it came out of. Then, since it says that face-up field spells cannot be destroyed by your opponent's card effects, not your card effects, guys. That's what's important here. That's what I'm leading up to here. That's another thing that makes this card good, is that you can still destroy your own field spells to get their effects. I don't know, if you want to get Cosmo Town's effect, you can. If you want to get Gear Town's effect, you can. Town. I don't know. Like, the thing is, guys, it protects your field spells from your opponent's card effects. And you can still blow up your stuff and combo off of it. It's good. It's great stuff. And also, like I was saying earlier, since it's got good link placement, it can be used as a starter or an extender because, you know, once again, it's got an arrow that points to the left, so you can, you know, already have something, you know, already have something, an extra monster zone, open up another zone to the left, for example, summon something else, or, you know, since it points down, you can use it as a starter, summon something underneath it, and of course, being a link 2, generic link 2, easy to make, you usually use it to climb up into something like, I don't know, Skull Dread, Boral Sword, something good. Now, there are some downsides to this card because he's not as kick-ass as he could be. For example, the first example here, he's only got 1,000 attack. 1,000 attack is pretty low, especially for a link monster that cannot go to defense position, so you're just gonna eat that damage if something attacks into him. But since he's usually used as a starter to go into something, you know, bigger like Skull Dread, like I was talking about a minute ago, or a second ago, whatever, yeah, it's not a big deal him having 1,000 attack because you're just gonna get him off the board anyways and build to something bigger, so the 1,000 attack, usually not that big of a deal. The other bad thing is the spell that you discarded a card for, you don't get that back from your graveyard until the end phase. It would be a lot better if it was immediate, you know, to get that immediate satisfaction, you know, that immediate, you know, card advantage back, but it's just nice having the discard outlets. Period. It's nice having a discard outlet that doesn't require the field spell to already be in your graveyard to get back during the end phase. That is something else that's very, very good. I cannot stress this enough. But at the same time, though, it would be really cool to have it to where you could activate it either way, how it is now, but still be able to get that back immediately. I'm trying to have my cake and eat it too, guys. Just okay? Outside of those two things, though, guys, I can't find anything wrong with this card at all. It's even a dark for chaos monsters. Like, it's even a dark. Like, lights and darks are just, like, typically the best attributes in Yu-Gi-Oh! Like, throughout history, lights and darks, best attribute in Yu-Gi-Oh! This guy's even a dark. And not only is he a dark, but he's a machine. Do you know how much machine support's out there to boots? Like, I mean, just off the top of my head right now, like, I don't know. Overload Fusion. He's a machine, right? You can, like, use him in the grave with Overload Fusion and get out, like, I don't know, Overdragon or something. Or if you're that worried about the 1,000 attack, I don't know, there's, what's it called? Limiter Removal. Yeah, like, Limiter Remover, whatever it's called. The thing is, there's tons of machine support, guys. That's my point here. There's tons of machine supports. This guy being a machine, being a dark, that just gives them good stats on top of having good arrows and a good effect. But you guys are gonna be asking, what the hell does this have to do with the ban list coming up? You said that this was gonna open up some sort of ban list discussion or something or another. This is what I signed up for and I'm not getting what I signed up for. I get it, okay? Look, it's really, really simple, guys. The Sky Striker engine allows you to make this card very easily and it gets you to a discard outlet through this guy very, very easily. And the Sky Striker engine really is the best generic link climbing engine in the game right now. That is why Hornet Drones is at one. That is why Kagari is at one, guys. It is the best generic. I mean, you can Engage is a great search card to boot, and none of them are once per turn. None of them are once per turn. And Engage, like I just said, is a fantastic search card. Being able to search and draw if you have the prerequisite spells, that is a plus. A search card that is a plus card if you've activated enough spells when a lot of decks, and like spell cards are like the best cards in Yu-Gi-Oh! Anyways, like, I mean, I was about to go on another tangent, but if you think about it, spell cards are like the best cards in Yu-Gi-Oh! Anyways, because a lot of the times they're pendulum scales, so they could be monsters too, like, or they're equipped spells, like Snatch Steals, take something, like, or, you know, Hero Live, special summon from deck. Spell cards typically are the best cards in Yu-Gi-Oh, guys. I mean, you get so much different. I mean, they do everything. They do everything, and they don't burn up your normal summon like a monster does, you know? So, like, spells, typically best cards in Yu-Gi-Oh. I mean, think about Sky Striker cards, guys. The only downside to these cards is that you can't have a monster in your main monster zone. But if you just used everything that you have to make Skulljet, for example, then your main monster zones are clear and you can Hornet Drones into Kagari and get that Hornet Drones back anyways. I got this typed out. Check this out. If you just cleared your board to summon a Dread, for example, and you draw an Engage off the Dread, and if you've already got some spells in your grave, you can search the drones, draw a card, activate the drones, summon Kagari, then of course get the Kagari, use the Kagari, get the drones back, and then maybe even later on use that drones that you got back. Again, you know, to keep building, keep extending, make an even more broken board. So of course it has been argued that since the engine is just that good, that generic and that good, Hornet Drones should go from 1 to 0. I strongly disagree. Man, I'm just gonna keep cheating. I don't even care. I'm just gonna keep cheating. I like the engine, so I am biased, but here's the thing. This game has gotten so fast. It really has. It has gotten so fast. Hand traps aren't even that good anymore. Actually, Cali Effect even did a video on that I saw recently. I haven't watched it, but I saw it, you know, come up in my feed. But he even did a video on that. So people were noticing that hand traps are being played less, they're not as powerful as they used to be. Ash Blossom, for example, you mainly play in Salamon Great, and less people are playing Ash. It's a great hand trap, it's the best generic hand trap, but it isn't as good as it could be because you're losing a card to stop one of your opponent's cards, and if you're going second, they're still most likely gonna end with a broken board that you're still gonna have to play over, and you have one less card to do it with. You see, like, hand traps aren't as good as they used to be, so moving on with my point here. Hand traps aren't even good anymore, and more players are opting not to run them at all. If you look at just the way decks have been built over the years and how much they've changed, how much deck building has changed over the years, guys. I don't even need this now because I already know what I'm talking about. So if you look at how deck building has changed, we have gone from, you know, playing more trap cards, really having to think about your card choices, to really looking at everything from a go standpoint, which isn't a bad thing. I like fast Yu-Gi-Oh, don't get me wrong. I liked decks back in the day that rewarded good deck building like that. Like, Infernity is a great example of a deck that rewarded good deck building. What I'm saying here, as a whole, we've gotten to the point that if you look at how decks are built, everything is a special summonable monster, and every card that's coming out is just special summonable for free. It's just, that's how it is. And I don't know about you guys, but in most of my decks, I'm not running more than, like, I don't know, 6 monsters that I want to normal summon. Something like that, depending on the deck, you know, and what, you get it, depends on the deck and stuff. But my point still remains the same either way, and it doesn't matter what you're playing, you don't want to clog, you don't want to hand clog with too many monsters that you have to normal summon. You don't want to do that, then it means you're probably going to lose. And since we've gotten to that point that you don't even want to run normal summonable monsters, that everything is just spam, everything is link as fast as possible, what's another engine? Seriously, what is another engine? That's my point. It's a pretty simple one. What's another engine? Plus, we have so many cards in Yu-Gi-Oh! We have Lava Golem, Volcanic Queen, we have Sphere Mode, we have the Kaijus, and those are just the ones that, like, tribute your opponent's stuff, right? And then we have stuff like Dark Ruler No More, and Evenly Matched, and just, I mean, we have, and more stuff that I'm not even thinking of right now, guys. We have so much stuff, not just for Link summoning, but we have so many board-breaking cards out in the game right now. Seriously, what's another engine? Better cards are just gonna keep coming out. It's inevitable. You know, we have another master rule change just around the corner. So, to add to my point of what's another engine, seriously, before a master rule change and stuff, why not just let it slide? Unless you're gonna make a drastic change to the game, like a big drastic change to the game before the master rule change that you're gonna do. What's the fucking point? Seriously, man, just let it slide. It's just a fun engine. The Sky Striker engine is just an easy target because it's generic and a lot of people are playing it. And then as your players, they're like, oh, I'm tired of seeing that. No, take advantage of it. It's a great engine. You know, use it to make better decks. For the love of God, get better, you know? And to further solidify, I don't know, my argument of just letting this slide or whatever, Konami in more recent years has done a better job with ban lists than they ever have before. You you guys are gonna be like, what? They don't even announce the dates anymore. Look, listen. Let's just take Duelist Alliance format. This is the most recent, best example of I can think of a list that just neutered and butchered everything, okay? Think about Duelist Alliance format. Shadal's best deck. Next set, we get Klee. Like, Klee's like an insanely good deck, and the Necroz is an insanely good deck. And it just was stacked, guys. It seriously was stacked. Like, here's an insanely good deck. Here's an insanely good deck. Here's an insanely good deck. And then they didn't touch those for a long time, and you had to play those decks. And those decks power crept everything that came out before them so hard, so unbelievably hard, guys. Oh my gosh, you couldn't play anything else. So you had all these decks that you had to play, and then a ban list comes along and neuters and butchers all of them. And then Konami goes, you're playing Pendulums now, or Cosmo. That is literally what happened. Those mass murder ban lists, as I call them, don't happen as often as they used to. They used to happen every few months. They'd be like, here's your deck, here's your good decks, like the one that murdered Dragon Rulers or anything else. The thing is, they would get people conditioned into playing these really good decks because everything that came out before them was just, you know, power crept so bad that they weren't even playable, and then they would just, you know, butcher everything. They would make it to where you had to buy new decks. They don't do that so bad anymore. They come out with cards more frequently than they used to. Decks, they leave alone longer than they used to. Sometimes incredibly too long, like Zoo format went incredibly too long. Now we're hearing things like Broadwool coming back or whatever, like, too dry. I can't remember, man, what the OCG did right now. I'm just saying, like, I don't care because, like, Zoo format went on for way too long. Leave them banned. Oh my gosh. But at the same time, though, what's another deck coming back? Like, that's what I'm saying here, guys. I want to support my own argument here. I hate Zoo, but at this point, what's another deck coming back? There's enough diversity and stuff. What's another deck coming back, guys? What's another engine in the game? My point still stands. Unless you're gonna do something totally insane before the new rule change, just leave it alone. Just leave it alone, let us play. You're gonna come out with more broken crap anyways, and people are gonna buy it because power creep is a thing, you know, let's be real. What's another deck? What's another engine right now? It's nothing. With the vast card pool we have these days, all the floodgates could come back to three and you would still have your best decks still being your best decks. I mean, seriously, guys, we're at a point to where we're talking about Pantheism coming back. Pantheism of the Monarchs. We're talking about a floodgate deck coming back. You cannot special summon from the extra deck. Domain the deck. We're talking about Pantheism coming back to three and making Monarchs a consistent floodgate deck again. That's what we're talking about. And we're talking about it because it wouldn't matter. That's what I'm saying. What's another deck? What's another engine? It's already all over the place anyways, guys. It's already all over the place. I'm excited to see what they do with the rule change, though, whenever it does come out. I'm tired of hearing all this stuff about it. Let's get some hints. Let's get rolling here. Another thing you guys are gonna want me to talk about, I'll probably make a video on it soon, the new Herald support card. Yeah, we'll get that made soon. I did see it. I did get some messages about it. Thank you guys for messaging me and letting me know about this stuff, by the way. It is appreciated, because I don't catch everything. I may be Yu-Gi-Oh! Jesus, but I do not catch everything. Especially because I have better things to do than play Yu-Gi-Oh! Even though I love Yu-Gi-Oh! I have better things to do, guys. And seriously, I don't have a preference on the list. Leave that Sky Striker engine alone, though. It's too fun. The cards look great. And once again, unless you're gonna make some sort of huge change, what's the point? Also, I like Barricade Board Locker. That's a cool card. Subscribe!